Detective George Knapp, call the Wildcard Line at 818-501-4109. The first-time caller line is 818-501-4721. To talk toll-free from east of the Rockies, call 800-825-5033. From west of the Rockies toll-free, call 800-618-8255. This is Coast to Coast AM with George Knapp.
The late Warren Zevon, lawyers, guns, and money, and we might add, aliens. We're talking about the UAP Task Force report released by the DNI, Director of National Intelligence, on Friday. A lot of reaction from the public, some of it negative, much of it positive. And the negative reaction is a lot about what was left out. You know, we were hoping to see some mention about nukes, for example. There's a lot of information that's floating around about UAP and their seeming interest in nuclear weapons, nuclear facilities, ICBM bases. Nothing in the public version of that report. Maybe it's in the congressional version. We're going to get back to our panel here, our posse, and ask them some questions and then open up the phone line, see what's on your mind here on Coast to Coast AM. In April alone, consumer prices increased by 4.2%, the highest bump since 2008. Higher fuel prices, food prices, construction costs, housing prices, inflation isn't just coming, it's here. And if you haven't diversified into precious metals, you're leaving your savings exposed. Birch Gold Group is who I trust to help you convert an IRA or eligible 401k into an IRA backed by gold and silver. That's right. Through a little-known tax loophole, you can convert your retirement savings that's tied to the stock market into an IRA backed by precious metals. It's your hedge against inflation. You can even buy physical gold delivered to your door. Get your free info kit on precious metal IRAs by going to birchgold.com/coast. With thousands of satisfied customers, an A-plus rating with the Better Business Bureau, and countless five-star reviews, Birch Gold can help you hedge against inflation, too. Go to birchgold.com/coast and invest in gold before it's too late. That's birchgold.com/coast.
Guys, waking up over and over to pee is not okay. But now, you can reduce those nighttime bathroom trips with the ingredients in Super Beta Prostate P3 Advanced. We're talking about less urges to pee at night, less bathroom trips during the day, and better bladder emptying. That's why Super Beta Prostate is the number one prostate supplement recommended by urologists. You can try a full 30-day bottle free. Just pay shipping and handling. No strings attached and no commitments to buy. This is a 30-day supply, absolutely free. Call 1-800-483-6019. Super Beta Prostate is the best-selling brand in major retailers like Walmart. But for this no-strings-attached free bottle, you must call now. Call 1-800-483-6019. Don't miss out on this unprecedented free offer. 1-800-483-6019. 1-800-483-6019.
UFO Joe, I'm sorry to interrupt you there. Did you want to finish that thought, or would you move on, or you have the option?
No, that was fine, George. I just want to say the most exciting thing for me the past, yet today, Eric Weinstein, the mathematician, deep thinker, he apologized to the UFO community. He has 500,000 followers. He's like, listen, I was wrong. You were right. There's more to this. I believe you now when you say there's more data. And I was like, I don't get emotional with this subject, but when I was reading that, I'm like, I had to hold back a little tear. I know some other people were the same. And then we saw Megyn Kelly, who's a massive name in media. She's asking Lou Elizondo the questions, the proper questions. She's like, what if these are everywhere and we just can't see them because our sensors aren't pointed at them? So I'm really encouraged by that kind of reporting, and we need more of it. You know, so that's something to look forward to. And I never thought I'd see that day where somebody, just mainstream people, are hammering home the right questions to ask.
Yeah, for Eric to sort of reverse position and admit he was wrong is an amazing thing. Danny, any of your comment on media coverage? I've seen some articles that are pretty inaccurate. The one I mentioned before about it was in Wired, where they say, oh, gosh, this is all we get for $22 million. And, of course, there wasn't $22 million in this. Anything else pop out at you?
I haven't been noticing a lot of the crazy long coverage. I'm sure it's always out there. I'm just noticing all the coverage in general, and it's great. And a lot of these media guys that weren't paying attention to it 6 months ago, 2 years ago, when we were contacting them, now they're doing it. And now they realize that this is a story that they can't ignore. It's just, it's amazing. Not only is it political, but it's mainstream media. And a lot of people say, well, we already know what's going on. Why do we need the government? Why do we need mainstream media? The UFO community knows what's going on, and the coast-to-coast audience knows what's going on. But unfortunately, the mainstream public that doesn't care, our family and friends that laugh at us, they do need the government, and they do need mainstream media, and that's why the sea change is so important.
Jeremy, you know, looking back, you know, this report left open the possibility, a very slim crack of the doorway, that this is foreign technology or secret American technology. Didn't take either of those off the table, even though they said there's no proof of either. And I can see the debunkers jumping on that, or the problems with censors too. They just use those phrases from the report when whatever their next wave of reporting might be. But, you know, what's forgotten is that we've been documenting these objects for a long time, we being the U.S. government, our military. 74 years ago, this past week, was the start of the modern UFO era. They were seeing the same kind of craft with the same kind of capabilities back then. I mean, did the Chinese have drones over Roswell or Los Alamos? Did the Russians fly over White Sands back then? I mean, the same kind of craft that are being reported today, some of them pretty exotic, were reported back then, right?
Yeah, look, we have lived in a data-rich environment for a long time. I think we need to embrace the fact that people are jumping in with both feet just in the last year or less. That is so exciting. To comment a couple things on what you guys said, I mean, oddly enough, very funny, like Eric Weinstein ended up calling me the other week, and, you know, that it was so bizarre to me. Here's an individual, a very bright-minded individual. Yes, we have common friends. That's how he got my number. It wasn't because I was doxxed, which I was, but he got my number. And we talked at length, and it was so interesting. You know, he wanted to, he was incensed that the brightest minds that he knows, that they weren't included in the UFO truth. And that was, and that's so important. It's so important. So I'm glad that we have people like Eric and other people that are looking at this academically and scientifically. It really gives me hope. It really gives me hope. So yeah, this phenomenon, it goes way back. Let's talk about something specific. I'm gonna drop this next week. I've just been looking it up, making sure I got everything right. But the whole idea of what, you know, Ryan Graves has reported, these cubes within spheres, this is nothing new. I have an article from 1960 from a major publication that talks about, by the way, flashing, that word, flashing UFOs that were square objects within spheres. This is from 1960, and not only did a military pilot see it, but also a commercial airline pilot. I will drop that original news article sometime next week. So this is nothing new. We need to be happy we're getting what we want. The world is embracing the UFO mystery. It is time to move forward.
And thinking about this subject, you know, how science is really, I understand how it ended up this way, that they were told, you know, this is a career killer. There's no grants for this kind of work. It's all nonsense. And you would interview, I've interviewed all kinds of scientists who are straight arrow folks who will, you know, they have inquisitive minds, but they wouldn't touch this subject with a 10-foot pole because they've been told there's no evidence. It can't be, therefore it isn't, kind of a thing. But I would think that for scientists, as with journalists, this is the biggest ever. There will be Nobel Prizes that will be given out on this eventually. If anybody could nail this down and confirm a non-human intelligence exists out there or here. So I would think any inquisitive scientist would knock down little old ladies to get at this subject matter. The same with journalists who are now finding out, hey, the public is really interested in this subject. You know, the reaction when we write a story about it is over the top. Jeremy, you first, then the other guys too.
Yeah, look, you know, it comes back to exposure. It's like what we're used to, this idea of pushing the boundaries of reality. We take for granted that, like, we will all embrace and accept different ideas. It's hard enough to navigate on social media opposing opinions. I can understand why individuals in prominent positions would completely dismiss the UFO topic because they don't want to be ridiculed. Look, people are human beings. They have feelings. I get it. But when you really focus in on this, it is an absolute failure of our scientific community. It's a failure of just the human approach to new knowledge. People were burned at the stake when we thought that we were, you know, the universe was moving around the Earth. Then we understood that we're all moving around the sun. And then we understand the universe is larger than that. It takes time. And I'm okay with that. It just takes time. So I think we're going to see a lot more engagement now with people that have a sort of permission that is being given to them. And I got to say it, by mass media. I mean, with having people like TMZ, having people like Discovery and Fox, and having these shows that I've been a part of and I'm going to continue to be a part of, I think it's really good. I think it brings everything into this place where people have permission to talk, to just ask the questions about what UFOs represent to humanity. I'm so inspired, you guys. I'm really inspired in this moment that we're going to make progress because of the openness of conversation.
Danny, same question. I mean, a lot of scientists out there are now having to reevaluate their lack of interest in the subject. And the same is true for journalists. I mean, all the articles are coming out. A lot of journalists around the world, mainstream people who have covered everything, suddenly have this task ahead to try to digest decades of UFO information and get their head around it.
And that's one of the main things about the report that people are forgetting. Journalists, we've been beating them over the head with facts and government reports now. And now that the report is out, they don't have a choice. They have to cover it. It's no longer their choice to just ignore it. And they have a lot of catching up to do. So now that this report is out, now that there's a task force and hopefully a permanent fixture, they're going to have to report it and they don't have a choice. And this is a big deal and the stigma will be gone.
Joe, same thing. Media and science both having to reevaluate their lack of interest in this subject matter for a long time.
And I think they're realizing, as you said, there are Nobel and Pulitzer Prizes awaiting whoever digs into this and gets us some answers. I think that's going to inspire some amazing media coverage. And look at the SETI website tonight, SETI.org. For the first time ever, they're more open about UFOs, you know, so... One of the big thorns in our side has been Seth Shostak, the lead astronomer, senior astronomer at SETI, and they're opening their minds. So that's like, if that's not different, the naysayers are like, this is really nothing different. This has been happening before. No, you're wrong. And SETI is the perfect example. If they can open their minds, anybody can.
Yeah, SETI and UFOs, they're not necessarily, contradictory. I mean, you can have both be true, that they're way out there and they're here too. So if that happens, that would be awesome. We'll take a call or two. First time caller, Paul in Anchorage. Hi, Paul. You're on with Jeremy, Joe, and Danny.
Hey, George. First of all, I met you a long time ago and I have a lot of respect for you. I want you to know that. Gentlemen, I don't like to ambush people, but I want to disparage you and chew you out in the most harshest of terms. I'd like to have your permission to do that rather than ambush you, if that's all right with you.
Yes, go for it.
Thank you, because I'm going to be harsh. I'm going to try to stay calm if possible. To hear you gentlemen give a positive spin on this moment is just disgusting in my world. And I want to give you a reason why, and I want to give you a resolution, and I want to make an emphasis on a point here.
Okay, Paul, remember, we're at 11:48 right now, so the program ends at 11:55, so I hope you're not going to do a 12-minute dialogue.
Well, I'm going to give whatever time you decide I get.
Okay, all right.
I trust people, but I'm going to tell you this. I am disgusted. I think you should be ashamed of yourselves, and here's my reason for this. I think of all the dead people, and I've been chasing these things for 30 years. I've never seen one, but I've seen the books of people who sacrificed their lives, their families, everything, and got disparaged and put in a grave over nothing. I think of those people. I think of a troubled nation in a world so divided now, and this issue is the epitome of everything we seek: energy, knowledge, understanding, a place in the universe. And yet you folks give these people cover for some of the most farcical reports I've seen in my lifetime, And you should be going after these people in the harshest of terms. These people should be, you should be demanding that every one of our legislatures set aside all their petty differences right now. And I want to see every damn picture in that damn file that goes back to 1960. Now, I understand secret stuff, but the point is that they have no right whatsoever to hold this stuff from us. And for you gentlemen to make out like you're some monolith or some new paradigm in our society, gentlemen, in my world, you're childlike in that attitude. And George, you know that. I've seen men sacrifice entire lives.
I'm really excited to answer because we have such little time. So is that all right, George? Can I?
Yeah, go for it. Gentlemen? Yeah.
Okay, look, I think that was a very respectful way to go about being angry. And that's cool. I absolutely share your anger. I share your frustration. However, the only way to make progress is to push forward from a place where you're going to have positive results. Do not think for one second that it is not infuriating how we are being shown little bits of information when I know firsthand there is more. So I would like to say thank you for being so respectful in the way you wanted to chew us out. But at the same time, please, you must respect. The only way to move forward is to face this head on and to use every means necessary to do so. So I appreciate you. I appreciate your passion. I really, really hope you can target and use that and focus that towards a positive goal as we are doing. Thank you for your time.
Yeah, I would say, Paul, that, I, as somebody who's been chasing this for 32, 33 years, banging my head against the wall, I feel the same way. I still see this as progress. And the UFO public to beat their chests and scream and yell and demand that we want to see everything and we want to see it right now has not worked. It has not worked. I think it's a good idea to keep the pressure on them, but there are secrets that need to be kept. The sensor systems that we have that's detected this information, that's collected this evidence, are sensitive and are classified for a really good reason. As one intelligence official told me one time, who has worked on this for a long time, he said, you can't tell your friends without telling your adversaries. I think there are some legitimate national security reasons for keeping some of that information from getting out. I think they've hidden behind national security for a long time in withholding information and lying to us. But I see a real change here. I think things really are changing. But thank you for calling in. Joe and Danny, do you want to also address it?
Yes. We are making a difference with media coverage. And also along those lines, why this hasn't come out, Luis Elizondo was asked recently if he believed there was an MJ-12-like group, and that's very controversial. And he said he had seen evidence that that group exists, and he had a very close colleague that said to him that there's an element within our government in the black that was interfering with their capabilities at ACIPS to collect and analyze data and information, a secret government-type group, and they would intimidate people. He personally hadn't had the experience, but a close colleague of him. So that's Luis Elizondo. So there's more than what more below the surface of what we're dealing with, but I agree with Paul, 100%. Don't have anything against what he said.
Danny?
The transparency that we're now seeing is what we're fighting for every day. And people like Jeremy and George, who are releasing the photos that were provided to them, is a huge step. Now we have politicians on the same side as the caller, asking for this information to be put out to the public. So I think that's huge.
Yeah, I mean, at this point, UFOs are not a voting issue. They don't decide that. That topic does not decide elections. People vote about the economy. They vote about, they love certain politicians, or they're worried about national security matters other than UFOs. So until it becomes a voting issue, you don't have a whole lot of pressure with which to affect how our lawmakers look at this. But there is progress being made. It's a really exciting time right now, and as I've said before, I never thought I would see this coming. The idea of we'd like everything you've got and we want it now is not a realistic position to have. We don't have enough power to force that, but progress is being made. This is a crack in the dam, and I'm very encouraged by it. Anyone else want to comment? We got about 30 seconds. So.
Yeah, inch by inch, life this inch, yard by yard, life this hard. Let Paul be a warning and a voice of the public.
We have a right to know, a need to know, and a responsibility to find out the truth about UFOs. So I thank Paul for calling in, and let's move forward.
All right, Jeremy Corbell, looking forward to some good stuff from you coming this week. And I want to remind you, you're on that Fox special that's airing Tuesday and involved with the Discovery Science Channel project on Wednesday. UFO Joe Mergia, and Danny Silva, Silver Record. We have links to you guys' contacts if people want to check out your stuff. You're always both always cranking out great content. Thank you guys for being here. And anything else to say?
No, very excited about what we're going to see coming up in the near future. And I can't wait to see what Jeremy releases next. On
Danny?
Tuesday, baby.
All right. All right. Danny, Joe, Jeremy, thanks very much. We go into the break with CCR, Tombstone Shadow.
Birds were chirping, the sun was shining.
And somewhere on a quiet residential street, a sink was clogging.
The couple experiencing the clog,
Mr. and Mrs. JP,
did something they had never done before. They called the Smell Good Plumbers at Mike Diamond.
I'm Mike Diamond. I guarantee my plumbers will show up on time and unclog your sink for $99.
A technician showed up promptly and unclogged the sink.
A few months later, a much more intensive problem turned up in the bathroom.
Mr. JP called Mike Diamond again. They worked up a plan and the repair was made.
Mr. and Mrs. JP felt good enough about the experience to sit down and write us an email.
They commended the Smell Good Plumbers on their service and closed by saying they would use Mike Diamond on future services and recommend them to anyone in need of plumbing repairs.
We love Mr. and Mrs. JP, and we'd love for you to read their testimonial and more before calling your next plumber. The address is MikeDiamond.com, or just call us at 1-800-446-MIKE. Contractor's license number 399-170.
Someone uses your toilet and it overflows. Can you imagine how embarrassing that is for your guests and for you? Hello, I'm John Okoyan, owner of Rooter Hero Plumbing. You're hosting a party, the water's on the floor, and your guest has to tell you that the toilet is backed up. And worst of all, you have to tell your guest that they can't use the bathroom. I shudder when I tell this story because it happened to me. Can you imagine? I own Rooter Hero Plumbing and my toilet overflowed. Talk about being humbled. Well, the truth is, it could happen to anyone. And the solution is to call 866-DRAIN-77. That's what I did, and our plumber was here within the hour. Not because I'm the owner, but that's just what we do. I'm so confident that you'll be satisfied with our services that I put my cell phone number on every business card. 866-DRAIN-77. That's 866-DRAIN-77.
Everybody needs a hero.
Yeah, 102-8886.
Well, at least you've decided to listen to KFI. See, you're making progress.
KFI, AM 640.
KFI.
And KOST HD2.
Los Angeles, Orange County. Live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
Shot and killed in Azusa. I'm Phil Jewlett from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. An investigation is underway after Azusa police shot and killed a man who allegedly was armed with a large kitchen knife. This neighbor describes what he heard when police confronted him.
I heard two small caliber shots, and then I heard probably about eight larger caliber shots. They were yelling at him, but I couldn't discern what they were saying.
According to investigators, the man charged officers with the knife twice. They used non-lethal rounds the first time, but when he came at them again, they opened fire. The search for survivors in Florida's condo collapse is entering a fifth day. Crews are digging through debris piled three stories high. Four more bodies were found yesterday. The death toll now 9. 152 people are still missing. You thought gas prices were high? They're going up again this week thanks to a scheduled increase of the state excise tax, a little more than a half cent per gallon. Right now, the average for a gallon of regular in L.A. County is $4.30. It's $4.26 in Orange County. The last cow rounded up among the group of 40 that escaped a slaughterhouse in Pico Rivera has arrived at her new home, where she'll get to live in peace.
You know, we do have feelings as humans for animals, and I think this symbolic gesture is that.
The cow was brought to the farm sanctuary in Acton on Saturday, 4 days after getting loose through an open gate and running several miles through neighborhoods. The Clippers will try to stay alive in the Western Conference Finals of the NBA playoffs. They're down 3-1 against the Suns and play Game 5 tonight in Phoenix. Southland weather from KFI, sunny and hot today. 110 possible in the Antelope Valley. San Fernando, San Gabriel Valley is around 100. Metro LA and OC can expect mid to upper 80s. Hazy sunshine to the beach, mid-70s there. Tuesday, clouds and about a 20% chance of thunderstorms. Right now, it's 66 in Cypress. Mission Viejo, 62. It's 64 in Brentwood, and in Calabasas, currently 63 degrees. We lead local. From the KFI 24-hour newsroom, I'm Phil Hewlett. It's a full freeway closure heading out of Buena Park this morning on the northbound side of the 5. All lanes shut down at Artesia Boulevard for a Caltrans project. Taking everybody off the freeway here as late as 5. You can get back on at Alondra. In Baldwin Park, it's a 605 North connector to the east on 10. You have a tractor trailer that broke down. It's in the right lane of the transition road. CHP's on scene. Linwood, westbound 105 at the 710. Clean up after a crash. Crews have the carpool lane blocks there. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Ryan Duggan.
We got a million reasons to visit Morongo, but we've only got a minute. So here's five. Now the top five reasons to visit Morongo. Number five.
At Morongo, you just get more. More games, more dining, more fun. More memories, more good times. Just come.
Number four.
It's officially summer, which means you officially need a cabana, a cocktail from Sunset Bar, and officially need to chill on the lazy river.
Three.
You play, you earn. You can pay with points. For a room? Cool. At Cielo? Fine. Got a gift? Go get it.
Number two.
Stimulate your senses at Page Spa. Try the hot rock massage.
And the number one reason.
We're sports fanatics. We've got big screens everywhere you eat, stay, and play. 7 days a week and 24 hours a day.
Morongo Casino Resort and Spa. Conveniently located on the I-10. Less than 90 minutes from wherever you are. Morongo. Good times!
Do you check your Google search results regularly? You should. People often get their first impression of you or your business online. Negative comments on the internet can impact your life and your livelihood. Take control of your online reputation. Get your free reputation report card at reputationdefender.com. It may reveal negative posts from an ex-employee, upset patient or client, news article, legal issue, or even exposed personal information right there in your Google search results. Uncover what's lurking on the internet about you with ReputationDefender.com's patented scan and get your free reputation report card. Or for immediate assistance with your reputation, call 800-644-7855. Our cutting-edge technology helps make your Google search results look their best. Call 800-644-7855. That's 800-644-7855. 800-644-7855. Or take the free scan at ReputationDefender.com.
Contractor license 1047781.
Wacky Zacky?
Yeah?
Do you know what time it is?
Look at your cell phone.
It's time for rejuvenation.
What?
Air conditioners work 24/7.
Uh-huh.
And rejuvenation brings them back to life, all rosy cheek, and it puts a spring in their step.
Well, so what's the benefit of rosy cheeks and a springy step?
Your AC will cool better, last longer, and use less energy.
You gonna clean my outside coals?
The right way, not the easy way.
And make all six critical adjustments?
Of course, we never do anything halfway.
What's this reju thing gonna cost me?
$129. But you're not saying it right.
How am I supposed to say it?
Rejuvenation.
If I say it wrong, you'll still come over and do it?
Sure.
G-O-E-T-T-L.
But it would be better if you said it right.
We do things well, but Kenny's crazy as... well...
Matter of fact, my first guy, it's a Beamer, the first time I got my car, for some reason there was a glitch in it. All he would do is talk to me in German,
and I'd scream,
you know, on cue, you're doing this on purpose!
Bill Handel, mornings from 6 to 10 on KFI.
It's good to be K.
Because then you have servants.
And then you control the servants' lives.
And that's what these guys love, is controlling other people's lives, telling them what to do.
Manipulating them.
John and Ken, weekdays 2 to 6 on KFI.
I literally am thunderstruck here.
I am, and this is not easy for me to admit,
I'm at a loss for words.
Bill Handel, mornings from 6 to 10 on KFI.
You're gonna have to read the details, because I'm a lady.
I don't even think this. Wait, because you're a lady? Come on!
Gary and Shannon, weekdays at 10 a.m. on KFI.
KFI, AM 640.
Into the program, a second half coming up. That's their song Deja Vu. Thanks again to Jeremy and Joe and Danny for joining us to talk about that task force report. You know, with so much public attention focused on UFOs, UAPs way up in the sky, there are military programs, sensor information, government studies of objects that are far away, lights in the sky kind of a thing. We tend to forget the people who have told us that they've had up close and personal encounters. One of the most remarkable experiences that's been documented occurred to Deborah Jordan Cobble. She's an ordinary woman who has a habit of attracting the extraordinary. After a terrifying, anomalous experience that she shared with author, pioneer researcher Bud Hopkins, her life took a dramatic turn. She became a central figure in Hopkins' best-selling landmark book, Intruders. There was a TV adaptation was done, a miniseries on CBS. And the series ended. The book has been out of print, I think, for a while, but it's back, and also back as Deborah's astonishing story. She has a book called Extraordinary Contact, Life Beyond Intruders, that updates all the things that have happened since, and wow, there are a lot of them. Deborah joins us in just a moment on Coast to Coast AM. You're smart to worry about age-related mental decline. I do, which is why I take Matter by Elysium Health. Matter is science, not some passing fad. It was developed in partnership with the University of Oxford to slow the brain loss that occurs as we age. Matter contains a patented formula that is clinically proven to slow age-related loss in the brain's memory centers by an average of 86%. To me, it's a miracle of modern science. Is brain health important to you? Here are questions to see if you need Matter. One, Have you noticed changes, even mild changes in your memory, too? Does any sort of memory decline run in your family? If you said yes, then take Matter by Elysium to help support your brain health today, tomorrow, and later in life. Go to trymatter.com/George and use promo code George at checkout to save $45. That's promo code George at trymatter.com/George. trymatter.com/George for $45 off.
Real people, real stories.
I have suffered for years and years, and it was one of those things that I was just willing to try most anything, and so I ordered the carnivora. I had acute eczema and hives. I had been to a minimum of 3 different dermatologists. They always gave me another cream or another ointment to put on that was supposed to help relieve the itching. I have tried every cream and ointment that you can imagine. I promise you, it was pretty miserable. So I started taking the carnivora, and at this point, I don't want to ever be without it. I don't want to go back there again.
Call 866-836-8735. That's 866-836-8735. Or visit carnivora.com. That's CARNIVORA.com.
Welcome back. This coming Wednesday marks the anniversary of an experience that changed the life trajectory for Deborah Jordan Cobble. I mentioned that she has written this new book, Extraordinary Contact, Life Beyond Intruders, and we're very happy to welcome her back to the program. Deborah, glad to have you here.
Well, I'm glad to be here. Thank you so much for asking me.
You know, I want to start with sort of that first half of conversation. This is not directly about your story, but you've heard these conversations about the UAP Task Force report, lights in the sky, strange objects, military programs. Great hubbub in media coverage and interest from the larger community, the world at large. Do you feel sort of left out? What we used to call abductees, now called experiencers, do you still feel sort of left out about this large conversation that's going on, but ignoring the people who've had close encounters?
Well, I'm just happy that people are talking about it and they're taking it seriously. You know, I mean, I remember when I first started talking about it in public, when we first started working with Bud, anything that I saw, we'd see on TV or hear about anything has to do with UFOs, period, was kind of a joke, you know, and people would, even the people who would report on them would smirk and laugh, and I'm just happy to see that not happening anymore. Baby steps, you know.
Yeah. Well, you know, I remember when I started chasing the subject back at the dawn of time, really the same year I think Intruders came out, that book, you know, the whole topic of abductions, alien abductions, was almost taboo in UFO world. You know, you go to a conference and the regular nuts and bolts saucer people weren't really comfortable talking about it, just as they years earlier had not been comfortable talking about aliens being in these craft or in the sky. Yvonne Smith, in the foreword to your book, she mentions about how it is still, to some degree, a fringe topic within a fringe topic. Do you still feel that way?
I don't feel that way as much now as I did back then, for sure. And I remember you, I mean, I've been a fan of yours for a long time. I'm sort of, you know, having little palpitations. Because I remember watching you and when you were reporting on Bob Lazar and all that, and I was so impressed with you and so happy with you because you were taking it seriously, you know, which wasn't being done a lot, and that made me very happy. So, but I think as time goes on now, once this has started coming out more mainstream, I think there's a whole new generation now of people that are interested in this and are investigating it, and these younger people, they're more open-minded, and I think that as time goes on, you're going to start to hear more about it. I remember when Bud first took our case, first answered my letters and stuff, he mentioned MUFON and CUFOS as two possible, organizations that might help us. But at the time, MUFON didn't have any desire to do anything for us. And then shortly after the June 83, I think in April of 84, my mother and I had another kind of spectacular thing happen over our house, and we actually got contact information from Bud to talk to Dr. Hynek, and he interviewed us, and we drew some pictures for him and stuff. But, at the time, MUFON really wasn't even, they didn't want to talk to us, because I had an abduction. They weren't interested in that.
Huh. Well, let's talk about Bud a little bit before we get into your story. Your book, Extraordinary Contact, Life Beyond Intruders, pays so much homage and respect, and there's a lot of love for Bud. Obviously, he's a major influence in your life. What a wonderful man he was. I mean, he gave me also so much of his time over the years that I knew him, and I saw him make multiple presentations. We did multiple interviews on radio and television, and he was a lovely man, a caring man, an incredibly talented artist, and a great and compelling writer, but just a really good person who cared about people. He was just a wonderful guy. I really miss him. And I know you feel the same way. Yeah. Yeah. Could you imagine what your life would be like if you had not written to Bud and he had not taken an interest in you?
No. I mean, many people have asked me, about that. And people also ask me, if you had a chance to do your life over again and you could not have these experiences, would you, choose not to have them? And I'm like, no, I wouldn't change a thing, because these experiences led me to Bud. And Bud, it's like he was a pivotal point in my life. There is actually nothing in my life today, or my life of my children even, that would be recognizable had it not been for him. I mean, everything that people don't think about, like I wouldn't have met my late husband, and then I wouldn't have met the husband I have now. My kids wouldn't have been here. They wouldn't have met their spouses, my grandkids. I mean, there's nothing that would be remotely the same. So,
well, if you were even still alive, I mean, abductees go through some.
I was getting ready to say, sometimes I think he saved my life, because I was a hot mess. I was a desperate and broken person when I reached out to him.
Tarzan.
1987 is when Intruders came out. His earlier book, Missing Time, both of them changed the landscape. They introduced the world to these subject matter, to these experiences. It affected Whitley Strieber, who wrote Communion after, his encounters with Bud. It inspired John Mack to get involved in it, even though they separated ways at one point. But, it made it respectable, and it made it acceptable for the UFO world to look into this stuff, even if they were uncomfortable. And it expanded our understanding of what these experiences are. They're not just close encounters that happen once and you meet an alien or you get probed on a ship or something like that. It's a much more complicated scenario. I was so glad to see your new book embrace sort of the wider range of experiences, how weird it gets. I mean, it's weird to begin with, the whole abduction scenario, but it's even weirder, as we're going to get into, right?
Oh, yeah. Yes. Definitely.
So let's talk about it.